Hi, this is Russell Stanhope from teachertrainingvideos.com. Today we're going to look at a technology that I've been using for many years. It's called Padlet. It used to be called Woolwisher. I remember it even more than 10 years ago. It's a great tool for getting your students to collaborate together in one place so they can write up their text or they can add links or they can add videos or pictures. And it's all displayed in one nice visual display. So it's great if you're looking to do a collaboration where you want some kind of visual display. Great for group work, great for brainstorming, great for projects. So I'm going to take you through using Padlet right from the start. So if you're someone with only a little knowledge of Padlet or you've never used it before, you're going to find this video really useful. Super quickly, just before we start, if you are an advanced user, click on the link above now and you can go to some advanced videos, and I'll also make this link available at the end. Let's get started. So I'm logged into my account. I'm going to show you some examples of the sorts of things that you can do with Padlet just to get an idea, and you'll certainly get more of an idea as I take you through the training. If we look at this one here, why should we use ICT with our students? I had a group of teachers that I was working with in Azerbaijan, and I wanted to get their opinions on using technology with students. So I created a Woolwisher, shared the link with them, they clicked on the link and added their ideas. All the ideas come together in one screen. You can see here, it just takes a few seconds to load, and I can see all of the people's opinions. And in this particular case, I asked them only to write text. But when students add up information onto a board, it can be video, it can be links, it can be pictures, or it can be text. In this particular case, I just wanted to get together everyone's ideas. Now, the nice thing about this afterwards is that we can then share this, so students can embed it into their blog, or share the link, or it can even be printed out. So it's just a great way of quickly collecting ideas together. Now this one here is a group work project. Students were working together and had to produce some information about the day, the way that Memorial Days around the world are recognized. And you'll see that there's both text and pictures. Okay, so that's another way that Padlets can be organized. And one of the nice things is that you can have different layouts. So you can have the Padlets across the screen or scrolling down the screen. So that's given you a couple of examples. I will show you some more as we work through. Let's get started and actually learn how to use Padlet. Okay, so all you need to do is to click on the sign up for free button. It'll bring you on to the screen, and then you've got a choice of either using your Google account or you can sign up through Microsoft. What I'm going to do is simply add in an email address and a password. Then once you've done that, simply click on the sign up button. Now with the free account, you can have up to 3 Padlets for free. And what you'll need to do is obviously when you want to reuse them is delete them and then you could use 3 again. So click on the basic account and it's going to bring you into your Padlet screen. So let's show you the quickest way to get started. You need to make a Padlet. So you're going to click here as soon as you've got an account ready. You've got various layouts here, and these layouts are something that they've introduced over the years. At the beginning, they didn't have any different types of layouts at all. The one that I quite like working with is the grid because it keeps all the information organized, but also another one is the stream where the posts go one underneath the other. I'm going to click on grid. I just click here. And the most important thing, first of all, to do once the Padlet is created is to make sure that you give your Padlet a name and a description. So I'm going to quickly do that now. So I've added a title, I've added a description. Now there are some settings here below that we'll come back to in the advanced videos, but really at the moment there's nothing there we need to worry about. Simply click on the next button, and then all you need to do is to click on start posting. Now the one thing you need to do then is to share the link with your students, and this is the really important part that I want to talk about. So you need now to decide how your students are going to access and add information onto the Padlet. And it's actually really easy to do. You just click on the share button here and it gives you quite a few options, okay? And if you come down to this button here, this is the important one. It is change privacy, okay? And what you can do here, you can have it as private, you can have it as password protected, you can have it as secret so no one can find it, and that's the default setting, or you can set it as public. Now I'm gonna start by just doing it as public. That means you have a link, you share the link with the students, and the students can simply access and write. You can do it so that they can do it with a password, but I'm going to show you first the quickest way, and this is often the way I'm working. If I'm in a class with a group of students, this is the way I work. So I'm going to click on save. Now all we need once we've done that is to actually click on this back button here to actually get that link then. And the link is here. We just simply come down and click on copy link to clipboard. And we've now got the URL and we need to share it with the students so they can access it. Now I'm going to show you a couple of tricks to help you to do that, because sometimes it's really difficult. You've got a link, and if you write the link up on the board or put it on your projector, then the students have got to write loads and loads of text because it's normally quite complicated. I'm going to show you a quick way of making that easier to share with your students. So this is the link that the students need to access the board and write up their ideas. Now obviously if you've got Edmodo, if you've got Moodle, and you've got a way of sharing that link, then it's very easy. If you write this on the board, this is quite a complicated link for people to write into their browser. One thing you can do is go to a website called Teeny URL and make that a little bit shorter. I'm just going to show you how to do that because that could save you and save your students a lot of time. So I'm going to go to Teeny URL, okay? Just click on teenyurl.com. And all I need to do is to add in the link. So I'm going to paste in that link and then make teeny. And it's going to make a much shorter version of that. Okay, and we can then copy to clipboard by just clicking here. Now if we come back and just paste that in to compare it to the original, you'll see it does make it much easier for the students to actually write in. So that's one way of making it easier for the students to write into their browser the link so that they can then obviously begin to write. So let's have a look then now at actually imagining that the students have got this link. So we'll copy that one, we'll actually use the Teeny URL one there. And I'm going to open up a browser and log in as if I was a student. So I'm just going to click on this browser here. So using a different browser, and I'm going to just paste in that link. Okay, so I'm just going to click on the address. Imagine that I've got that link now, that Teeny URL, and I'm going to click on enter, and it's going to bring me straight into the screen, to the Padlet, and now as a student, all I need to do is double click, and it's going to open up a window where I can upload, I can add a link, I can add pictures, etc. So I'm just going to write in my title, which is going to be my name, so that they know who I am, who's given this opinion, and I'm going to just quickly write something. So we'll make this just text-based. I'm going to say, I love screen capture technology, which is obviously the technology that I work with the most. It's the technology I'm using to make this particular video. I press on enter. That now is added onto the screen. And if I come back now as a student, back as the teacher, I will be able to see exactly what was written. So here I am back as the teacher, and I can see that Russell, the first student, has written something onto the screen and it immediately appears. So I could be project this on the screen and the students write up their ideas, it all comes together. Now it's important to realize that we're not limited to simply working with text. I generally use it with text, but you can get students to add up other content. Let's have a quick look at that. So just to make it clear that you can add other content, again, double click anywhere on the screen, another window is going to open. I'm going to write the title, which is going to be my name, so the teacher knows who I am. And then as you can see, I've got these other options. For example, I could click on link, and then I could add in a link to a web page. So let's perhaps just add my own web page. So I'm just going to paste in here, I've already copied it, the link to my website, and click on save. And now what we've done is we've added a link to a website. If we jump back now and look at what the teacher sees, so we're now back in the teacher's view, the teacher can clearly see that this student, again it's Russell, has added up a link to a page. So you can see you can add lots of different content onto the site. Now, when you make a Padlet, or when you create an account, you're limited to three Padlets. And a lot of people say to me, well, Russell, what's the point in using it? Well, obviously, what you can do is, once you've used your three, is delete one, and then you can therefore work on and create another one. But before you delete it, there's a couple of great things that you can do. And these features work really well. And I'm going to show you one of them. We've got this one here, what is blended learning. I'm going to click on the share button, and I'm going to come down here. And I am actually going to save this. Before I delete it, I'm going to save it as a PDF file. And I'm going to click on this button here, and it's so quick and it does such a good job. I'll use the basic settings. I'm going to click on publish PDF, and you're going to see now it's going to create, turn that into a PDF file. There it is, and it's on my computer. I can save that now onto my computer and then share it with my students. I can just very easily click on this button here and download that PDF file. And that is a great feature, and it really means that once you've done a wall wisher, you can then turn it into a PDF file, share it with your students, and then they can put it into their blogs or into their portfolios, or you can put it up onto Moodle, or you can put it onto Moodle, etc. Sometimes you might prefer to make it as an image rather than as a PDF file, and you can also do that again if you click on the share button and come down to below the share. You'll notice that you've got here save as an image, and if you click on that, it will just take a few seconds to produce, and then you're going to get the image onto the screen. Let me just have a quick look. In fact, I've got one here already produced. There is the image, and you can see that you can also do it that way as well. I prefer the PDF file generally, but sometimes an image is better, particularly if you want to kind of put it into a blog or put it into a website or something like that. But that can be a great way to save all the Padlets that you've ever produced. Then you can delete it afterwards, and then obviously make a new Padlet. You're always limited to having three Padlets. Okay, so your Padlet's made, your students have added up all their technology, you've got it there on the screen that you can project to the students. Once you've finished and everyone's put up their ideas, just simply click on the Padlet button here. There's nothing to save. One important thing for you is going to be the ability, because you're limited to having three Padlets. Once you've used a Padlet for a couple of weeks and you've done the work with the students, then obviously what you will need to do is to click and delete it, because if you want to make another Padlet, then you're going to want to make sure that you've only got up to three Padlets available. Now, luckily, because I've been using my account for so long, I've actually got or been given permission to have many more than three Padlets, but normally you are limited in a new account to three Padlets. Okay, I hope that really helped you. Above now is the link to the advanced set of videos for using Padlet. Some of the other things that you can do with Padlet, including you can make Padlet's password protected. You can also allow other students to add comments to Padlet. So if you want to use a Padlet for a discussion, then you can do that. So people can add up contributions and then other people can comment on them. We haven't looked at uploading video into a Padlet, which we can also do. And we haven't looked at the many different layouts that are available. We just use the simple grid Padlet. So the advanced feature is going to show you many more of the different ways that you can work with Padlet, and it can be quite a creative tool. I really hope you like this video. If you did, please help me to build up my YouTube channel. Please comment on my video. Please like the video. Please share the video with other teachers. And of course, if you haven't already, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. And thank you very much. If you're looking for more free content, please come to teachertrainingvideos.com. Lots of different technologies that I deal with. You can just click on any of these technologies here at the top and it'll open a video. Just click on the video and then you can play it. If you want to keep up with my work, there's really two things you can do. If you want to keep up with all the latest stuff, then sign up to the newsletter. That way you'll be updated on all my webinars, my online courses, my face-to-face courses where I'm presenting, as well as, of course, all the new articles and videos that I create. If you're looking for all the backdated material that I produce, the best place to go is to my YouTube channel. If you go there, don't forget to subscribe and to click on the bell. That way you'll be updated with all the latest videos. Those are the two best places. And finally, if you're looking for training, I do training all over the world, do some online training as well through Zoom and Adobe Connect. If you want me to do a presentation, then please just contact me, and you can contact me at the bottom of the page. And thank you very much. Here are three links to three different sets of videos that I think you might find useful to continue your studies. All you need to do is click on them and they'll open up straight away.